motion paths. Oh, how I
hate them.
But it was you guys over on Twitter who decided to torture me with this. Follow me at Skitty Animates if you want to participate in the next poll. So I can only assume that you all hate them too, and let's just suffer through this together. Motion paths are great for things like vehicles, roller coasters, snakes, all kinds of other things. They work by attaching an object to a curve, and the great thing about them is that they don't show up in your renders. But let's just get the elephant out of the room here. Yes, I do hate motion paths. My issue with them is that if you mess up one little thing, the curve breaks, and they're super prone to crashing Maya. Maybe take some notes about the order of operations in this video, and try to remember to save every, like, 2 minutes. There are two ways to set up your motion paths, and we're going to go over both of them. Option one, by moving the object. First, select your object and move it to where you want your starting position to be. Select the frame on your time slider you want the path to start, and on the animation tab, go to constrain, motion paths, set motion path key. This will create a single CV curve point. Now go to the next frame you want to set a position, move the object, and go to constrain, motion paths, set motion path key again. See how it created a straight curve between your points? You can rinse and repeat this as many times as you'd like. If after making a few points you want to go back and adjust some, you have a couple of options. You can go back to the key you want to change, move the object, and hit set motion path key to overwrite the existing key, or with the curve selected, you can hold right click and select control vertex. This allows you to select any key point you've made on the path and adjust its position with the move tool. The more points you add to the curve the better, because you can always delete unnecessary keys later. If after you place all of your points you want to close the curve to create a loop like a racetrack, right click to go back to object mode, select your path, and on the modeling tab, go up to curves and hit open close. Option 2! Attaching a pre-made path. I find this method much easier to work with. First, I'm going to switch my viewport to top view to ensure the curve snaps flat to the grid by holding down spacebar, right-click, and selecting top view. Make sure you do this while hovering the panel you want to change. Now in the Create menu, select Curve Tools, CV Curve Tool. Now we can draw as many points as we want. Once you're done placing your points, you can go back to the Modeling tab and open-close your curve in the Curves tab if you like. Next, you'll want to expand or collapse your time slider to only show the area you want the path to move. So if you only want the path to move from frame 20 to frame 80, only show that segment. Next, select your object, then your curve, go back to the Animation tab, and in the Constrain menu, select Motion Paths, and hit the option box next to Attach to Motion Path. In here, you can also change the start and end time of the path, though we won't need to, so I'll keep this selected on time slider. Ensure that follow is checked or else the object won't follow the curve and hit apply. You can also attach multiple objects to a path at once, just make sure you select the curve last. Now that we have the object on the path, let's look at some editing tools we have access to. If we select the attached object, the channel box will have motion path under inputs. Click on it to view a few options. Front, up, and side twist help us change the direction the object is facing. To change these, simply click on the text and middle mouse drag in your viewport. U value is the object's placement on the curve, but it also affects the object's timing. U value of 0 is your starting position, and U value of 1 is your ending position. To make a section of your path slower than the rest, go to the frame you want the speed to change, right click on U value, and hit key selected. Now move the time slider to where you want the speed to go back to normal, click the word U value, and middle mouse shift to the left to lower the U value. To make that section faster instead of slower, raise the U value on your second key instead. Selecting the motion path and hitting Control A to bring up your attribute editor, we have some more options in the Motion Path tab. Expanding Motion Path attributes, we can check the option Bank, which will make the object tilt on turns, like for example a motorbike going around a turn. You can also set keys on the front, up, and side twist if you'd like to animate it manually. For this next option, I'm going to edit the path to have a lot of bumps in it. With the object selected, go back to the Constrain menu, Motion Paths, and hit the option box next to Flow Path Object. What this does is creates a lattice around the object to deform it with the curve. My unprofessional terminology is, it makes it noodle. So with this option box, we're going to tell it how many subdivisions we want on each axis. Determine which axis corresponds to each twist control before deciding, because that's unfortunately what this tool works with. Once you've decided, hit apply and watch it noodle. The last option we're going to look at is offsetting the object from the path. To do this, select your object, go to your move tool, and hold down the D key on your keyboard. This will make a dot appear on the object's pivot point. Click that dot and left mouse drag. The object will move in the opposite direction of your mouse, but the pivot point will always stay on the path. So, what do you think about motion paths? Personally, I prefer motion trails, and I use them as often as I can get away with. I'll dedicate a video to those sometime in the future. Let me know in the comments below how many times Maya crashed on you while trying to learn motion paths. While making this video, I had 5. Leave a comment below if there's something you didn't understand. Like and subscribe if you learned something. Links to socials are in the description, and remember to always use a reference.